dear students, welcome back to the maths class. In today's class, we are going to do revision of chapter 1. Okay, we will revise all the topics with whatever we have discussed from exercise 1.1 to exercise 1.6. I'm not giving you the hints for what will come in your exam. Okay, I'm just revising all the topics. Everything you need to do, practice at home. Okay, so I'm starting from Indian system and international system. How we read the numbers in the Indian system and in international system, how we separate them by commas. Suppose we have a number.
Represents crore. So 4 crore, 52 lakhs, 81
thousands. Now it is a three digit number. So how we will read? We read 300 and 6 and 9 are in tens in one place. So we will read both the digits together. So 4,52,81,369. Now the same number in international, how we read it? 50,45,000,000. Now 281, it is a three digit number. So you know how to read three digit number. So 281,000. Now 369, this number is also three digit number. So 369, 45,281,369. So these are the ways to put or place commas and reading of the number in Indian system and international system. Next topic what we discussed is place value. How to find a place value of a given number? So let us understand it by an example. Your question is find the place value of 6 in the number 32,681. So if you remember the formula, what was the formula? Place value of a digit, we remember all this formula. Place value of a digit is equals to digit multiplied by its position. Digit multiplied by its position. Here, according to question, you want to find the place value of digit 6. So what we will write? We will write place value of 6 is equals to, what is the digit? Digit is 6. So at the place of digit we will write 6. Okay, then according to formula multiply symbol is there, so put the multiplication symbol. Now its position, whose position? Here we are talking about the digit's position. So digit 6 position is here. 1 is located at 1's place, 8 is located at 10's place, 6 is located at 100's place. So the position of digit 6 is 100. So we will multiply by 100. Now multiply 6 with 100. When we multiply 6 with 100, our result is 600. So we conclude now that the place value of 6 in 32,681 is 600. Now if I change my number, write the place value of 3. The same formula we will use as we are finding the place value. We are finding the place value of digit 3. This digit we are finding. So we will write place value of 3 is equals to, the digit is 3. For 3 we are finding. So digit is 3. Multiply according to formula. Now its position, what is the position of digit 3? Position of digit 3 is 10,000. So we will multiply 3 with 10,000. Now multiply 3 with 10,000, we will get 30,000, right? So here the position of 3 is 30,000. The place value of 3 is 30,000. Now I am changing the number, okay? Find the place value of digit 5 in 5 lakh. Find the place value of digit 5 in 5 lakh. So place value of 5 is equals to, for what digit we are finding place value? For 5 we are finding. So I will write 5 at the place of digit. Then multiply symbol is there, so put multiply symbol. And its position. So what is the position of 5? Where it is located? So let us see. This 0 is located at 1's place. This 0 is at 10's. Then hundreds, thousands, 10,000s and lakhs. So the place value of this 5, its position of this 5 is lakhs. So we will multiply with 1 lakh. 1 followed by 50 is known as 1 lakh. 1 followed by 50 is 1 lakh. Now multiply this 5 with 1 lakh. 5 into 1 lakh is 5 lakh. So what is the place value of 5 in 5 lakh? Our result is 5 lakh. Do not confuse, okay? Don't get confused. The place value of 5 in 5 lakh is 5 lakh. After solving, we are concluding it, okay? So this is how we find the place values. Now, how to write the given numbers in expanded form. Next topic is how to write given number in expanded form. Suppose the number revising all the topics whatever we have discussed in chapter 1. Okay, so how you will write this number in expanded form? Expanded form, it means enlarged form. Or we write the numbers in according to their place values. Okay, in addition form we write. So given number is 3,12,695, right? The first digit of the number is 3, so write 3 and put the number of zeros, count the number of digits after 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, total 5 digits are there, so place 5 zeros after 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and put a plus sign. Now we have done with the 3, so now which one is the next digit? Digit 1. So write 1 and count the digits after 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 digits are there. So put 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. And put a plus symbol. Now we have done with the 1. Now which one is the next digit after 1? Just after 1, 2 is there. So write 2. And after 2, count the number of digits. How many digits after 2? 1, 2, 3 digits are there. So put 3 zeros. 1, 2, 3. And put a plus sign. Now, we have done with the 2. Now, which digit is there? 6 is there. So write 6. After 6, how many digits left? 1 and 2. Only 2 digits left. So put 2 zeros. Then put a plus sign. Okay, now after 6, we reached at 9, the digit 9. So we will write 9. Now count the number of digit after 9. How many digit left after 9? Only one digit. So we will put only one zero after 9. And put the plus sign. After 9, what is written? 5 is written. 5 is written here, so we will write 5. Now, as there is no any digit left after the 5, so we are not going to put any digit after 5. So this is how we write the numbers in expanded form. This is the one way to write, or one more way we can write this in expanded form. just write the place values of 5, 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 and leg. Here 3 is located at leg's position. So we will write 3 leg. 3 followed by 5, 0 is 3 leg plus. The next digit is 1. 1 is located at 10,000 place. So we will add 10,000 to it. Plus 2. 2 is located at 1000's place. So we add 2000. Plus 6. 6 is located at 100 place. So we will add 600. Plus 9 is positioned or located at 10th place. So we will multiply. Sorry, we will add 90. Plus 5 is located at 1's place. So place value of 5 is 5. So these are the two ways to write in expanded form. You can follow this method or this method. Any of the method you can use to get your answer. So this is how we write the numbers in expanded form. Write this expanded number in short form. So, what is the step to write? First of all, arrange all these numbers, all these given numbers in column, and then add them and get your result. Do not write the first digits of your number. Some of you do these things, but do not use the short tricks for it. Okay. For writing in short form, arrange all the given numbers column wise first, then add them. So your first number is 5000, so write 5000. Next number is 2020. Arrange all the given numbers properly according to their places. Next number is 1, so write 1. Next number is 20,000. Okay. I have arranged all the given numbers in column. Now I will add them. See, if you write first digits of all the numbers, 5, 2, 1, 2. So your result will be 5, 2, 1, 2, which is wrong. See how it is wrong. 0 plus 0 plus 1 plus 0 is 1. Now add the digits in the next column. 0 plus 2 plus 0 is 2. Now add the digits in the next column. 0, 0 plus 0 is 0. 5 plus 0 is 5 and 2 as it is. So your result is 25,021. But if you write first digit of the number, what was your answer? 5212, which is wrong. So do not use the short tricks. Use the process, okay? How we get the short form? Arrange the numbers column wise and then add them. So your result is 25,021 is your answer. This is how we find the short form of the given number. Topic is comparison of numbers, comparison of large numbers. So suppose we have two numbers, and you want to compare these numbers by using the sign greater than, less than, or equal to. compare the number. There were some rules which I have discussed with you. The very first rule is count the number of digits in both the numbers. So let us count. In this number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 digits are there. And in this number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 digits are there. Both the number having same number of digits. So now we will compare the digits at the leftmost side. Both the number having two. This number have two, this number have two. Equal, we cannot conclude which one is greater or less. So compare the next digit. This side the number is 3, another side the number is 3. Both are equal, again we cannot conclude which one is bigger or smaller or equal. Now check the next digit. So when we check the next digit, one number is having 7 and other number is having 4. Now out of 4, between 4 and 7, which number is greater? 7 is greater. So we conclude that this number is greater. 23,73,452 is greater than 23,47,253. This is how we compare the number. Now let us take another example of comparison of numbers. Compare two numbers. So first step is count the number of digits in both the numbers. The number which have more digits will be greater. So let us count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This number have 6 digits. Now count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This number also have 6 digits, means equal number of digits. So we cannot conclude here are they equal, greater or lesser, which one is greater. Now check the leftmost digit of both the numbers. This number have 4, this number also have 4. Both the numbers are equal, we cannot conclude. So we will check the next digit. Now this number have 6, the other number also have 6. 6 is equals to 6. Again we cannot conclude. Now check the next digit, which is 3 here, and in this number 3 here. So again 3 is equals to 3. Now check the next digit. When we check the next digit, here 7, this side also 7, both are equal. Now check the next digit. This number is 7, the other number is also 7, means equal. Now check the last digit. So both the number have 6 at the last place. Means equal. All digits are equal. So we conclude that both the given numbers are equal. Okay? So this is how we do comparison. Topic is ascending order and descending order. So ascending and descending order, both the orders needs comparison. Okay, so if you know comparison very well, you can do ascending and descending order. In ascending order we arrange numbers from smallest to greatest, and in descending order we arrange numbers from largest to smallest. So practice these questions also. Now next topic is form the largest number. Form the largest number using the given digits. So suppose digits are given like 9, 4, 1, 5, 2, these given digits form a largest number. So how you will form, just remember one thing, to form largest number you will arrange all the given digits without using comma. You will arrange all the given digits in descending order. You will arrange all the given digits in descending order without using comma. So we have these digits in descending order. How we arrange the numbers? The largest number comes first. So among these 9, 4, 1, 5, 2 and 8, which one is largest? 9 is largest. So we will write 9 first. Then 9 is, we have done with the 9. Now we have left with 4, 1, 5, 2 and 8. So among these digits, which one is largest one? Which digit is largest? Here 8 is largest. So we will write 8. Now we have done with the 8 also. Now we have 4, 1, 5 and 2. 4 digits we have. 4, 1, 5 and 2. Among these digits, which one is largest? Out of these 4 digits, which one is largest? 5 is largest. So we will write 5. Okay, now we have 3 digits. 4, 1 and 2. Okay, 3 digits we have. Now identify which one is largest among these 3. 4 is largest. So we will write 4. Now we have left with only 2 digits, that is 1 and 2. So between 1 and 2, which one is largest? 2 is largest. So we will write 2. And at the last we will write 1. So the largest number using these digits is 985,421 is the largest number using these digits. One more time I am recalling how we find the largest number using the given digits. We arrange the given digits in descending order without putting the commas. Now next topic is form the smallest number using given digit. Suppose these are the given digits 7, 2, 6, 1 and 8. Okay, using these digits, form a smallest number. You want to form a smallest number. So to form a smallest number, what we do? We arrange these given digits in ascending order. In ascending order, we arrange these digits to form a smallest number. Okay, and what is the ascending order? When we arrange numbers from smallest to largest. So we need to find the smallest one among these given numbers. So out of 7, 2, 6, 1 and 8, 1 is smallest. So we will write 1 first. Okay. So 1 is smallest, so we will write 1. Okay, now we have done with the 1. Now how many digits are left? 1, 2, 3, 4 digits are left. That is 7, 2, 6 and 8 are left. Out of these 4 digits, which one is the smallest number? 2 is the smallest, right? So the next number we will write will be 2. Now we have left with the 3 digits, 7, 6 and 8, and we want to find the smallest one. Which one is the smallest among these 3? 7, 6 or 8, which one is the smallest? Identify. 6 is the smallest, so write 6. Now we have only 2 numbers left, which is 7 and 8. So which one is the smallest among 7 and 8? Between 7 and 8, which one is the smallest? 7 is the smallest. And at the last we will write 8. So using these given digits, the smallest number is 12,678. So this is how we write the number in smallest form and largest form. We remember, if you want to arrange numbers in largest form, largest number you want to make, so arrange all the digits in descending order. And if you want to form a smallest number, then arrange the digits in ascending order. Now last topic, which is Roman numerals. So I have discussed rules for Roman numerals already when we have started the chapter. Okay, all of you says 1.6, you need to practice very properly. I am just writing the 7 basic Roman numerals. We remember there are 7 basic Roman numerals which are the first Roman numeral is I. In Hindu Arabic numeral we represent by 1. We remember one more thing, there is no symbol for zero in Roman system. In Roman system, there is no symbol for zero. The next basic Roman numeral is V, capital letter V. And in Hindu Arabic numeral, we write 5 for it. Okay? The next Roman numeral is X, which we denote by 10. Okay, the next Roman numeral is 50, which we denote by L in Roman numeral. The next number is 100. In Roman system, we denote it by the capital letter C. And the next number is 500. We denote it by the letter D. And the next number is 1000, which we denote by the capital letter M. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are the 7 basic Roman numerals. By the combination of these letters, we can form any Roman number. Okay? We can form any Roman number for the given Hindu Arabic number. So these are the basic 7 numbers. Learn all these numbers and a rule also. Okay? I will provide you the worksheet also based on this chapter. Lecture is over. If you have any doubt, you can re-watch the videos in which we have studied this chapter 1. You can re-watch these videos on YouTube. If you still have any doubt, then you can take help of your parents, okay? And you, your copy is also completed, so you can see your where you are lacking.